Mrs. Smith, she says, I'm sorry, as you yelp at a passerby. But deep down she's really happy, with a twinkle in her eye. You're doing what she bought you for in sunshine, snow and rain. Sniffing around the garden fence, protecting the domain. Because you're a skittery duck, and you don't scare me. You're barking up the wrong tree, in your mouth I'll put a plug. You're a skittery duck. Skittery duck, you don't scare me. I'll flush you down the lavatory. I'll tape up your wee mug. You're a skittery duck. When night has fallen, Mr. Smith takes you out to do what's natural. You both sneak down the railway path, a practice not unusual. With your royal steward, tartan waistcoat, you lead him on at such a pace. You weigh just less than a kilogram, with a pointed nose and a furry face. You're a skittery duck, and you don't scare me. You're barking up the wrong tree, in your mouth I'll put a plug. You're a skittery duck. Skittery duck, what would you do if you were left out in the wild? Would you stand and shiver fearfully, like a lost and lonely orphan child? And a child is what you are to Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Something to hold on to precious, something to go walkies the gap, give the Smiths much needed lost pride, dragging them round the neighbourhood. That practice looks undignified. When they bought you from the shop, they thought you were something special, but somehow you've never quite managed to live up to your potential. You're a skittery duck, and you don't scare me. You're barking up the wrong tree, in your mouth I'll put a plug. You're a skittery duck. Skittery duck, you don't scare me. I'll flush you down the lavatory. I'll tape up your wee mug. You're a skittery duck. Oh, skittery duck, you don't scare me. You're barking up the wrong tree. Your grave I will have dug. You're a skittery duck.